Welcome to another Bleistift video. And today I want to talk about Staedtler's leads for their lead holders. Why do I talk about it? For some unexpected reason, my video about the 502 lead tap. What's the official name? Lead point sharpener? Lead tap? Not sure. For some reason, I didn't expect that it's my most popular video, and I basically just show how this sharpener works. Yeah. There's something else that maybe is not very obvious, so I thought I'll just explain it, and it's about lead holders. Now, a few years ago, Helmut Hufnagel updated the classic Staedtler lead holder, and it now has a lead hardness indicator. The story how this came to be is quite interesting. I wrote about it in my blog. But basically he spotted a famous designer, the designer who originally designed the VW Golf and other really interestingly designed items. He spotted how he's using Staedtler lead holders, and he uses little tapes to mark them, presumably to indicate what kind of lead is inside. He then thought, oh, we can help the good man. When I talked to him at a trade fair, that's kind of the words he used, and in German, or at least in Franconia, where he's from and where I'm from. That's how you'd say it. So he thought he's gonna introduce this lead hardness indicator, a bit like what you get on mechanical pencils, but it's not really that common for it's not really that common for lead holders. I think there's a reason why it's not that common, and that reason is that the lead holder packaging normally comes with a colored push button, and you can then see from the color of the push button what kind of lead hardness you got. Now, there's only one problem. Normally the push button has some sort of emergency eraser inside. Yeah, so you could, if you had to, you could sharpen your lead holder here. I think I prefer a proper sharpener, because you got the graphite dust flying around. But basically, if you buy a pack of 12 of these leads, come with a colored push button that indicates the hardness of the lead, and it's hidden in here. Quite clever. And yeah. So how he came up with this idea of, people ignore the push button, maybe because they don't want to lose this sharpening functionality, is quite clever. He saw the problem happening somewhere else, and it reminded me of another story from somebody else from that area. Staedtler is from Nuremberg, Adidas is from near Nuremberg, and there's that famous story where the boss of Adidas was equipping teams with their shoes, and there was an athlete in Montreal in 1976 who was kind of running unevenly, and Adidasler, the boss of Adidas, the brother of the boss of Puma, he saw this on the telly at home, in northern Bavaria, and he realized what's wrong with the shoes, and he called the people in Montreal in Canada, and they kind of remotely advised them what to fix so that this athlete could run faster. So I found this story, how Helmut Hufnagel solved somebody else's problem from far away, quite interesting. But it also brings me to talking about how clever this packaging actually is. Yeah. So first thing is, you can have your colored push button here. Second point here is you can slide this open. Now you have access to the LEDs. You can close it, and if you don't want it to open accidentally, you can just slide this down, especially if you don't store the cap in there, if it's on the back of your pencil. And now there's no chance of this opening. Yeah. Can't even open it if I wanted to. So I think the packaging is very clever, and I'm happy they're still using it to this date. And here, it's just a little thing I wanted to show you, especially because LED holders are not that common among stationary fans, so you might not have come across it. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.